लीगल 21 द क्लियर मैसेज इज दैट इट इज़ टू बी ट्रीटेड एज चार्ज मेड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम एंड ट्रायल हैज़ टू प्रोसीड फ्रॉम दैट स्टेज दिस पोजिशन बिकम्स फर्दर क्लियर फ्रॉम द बेयर रीडिंग ऑफ सब सेक्शन 4 ऑफ सेक्शन 216 ऑफ द कोड विच एम्पावर्स द कोर्ट इन सच ए सिचुएशन टू आइदर डायरेक्ट ए न्यू ट्रायल और adjourn the trial for such period as may be necessary. A new trial is insisted if the charge is altogether different and distinct. Para, even if the charge may be of same species and provisions for adjourning, the trial is made to give sufficient opportunity to the accused to prepare and defend himself. It is in the same process, Section 217 of the Code provides both that whenever a change is altered or added by the court after the commencement of the trial, the prosecutor as well as the accused shall be allowed to recall or re-summons or examine any witnesses who have already been examined with reference to such alteration or addition. In such circumstances, the court is to even allow any further witness which the court thinks to be material in regard to the altered or additional charge. Para, when we apply the aforesaid principles to the fact of this case, the outcome becomes obvious. The accused person were initially charged for an offence under Section 306 of the IPC, that is abetting suicide, which was allegedly committed by Dr. Prasad. It is manifest there from that the entire case of the prosecution, even after repeated investigation and medical examination of the dead body, skeleton of Dr. Prasad was that the cause of the death was suicide. Thus, after the investigation, what the prosecution found was that Dr. Prasad had committed suicide, and as per the prosecution, the three appellants had added and abetted the said suicide, which was committed by Dr. Prasad. On this specific charge, 26 witnesses were examined and cross-examined by the appellants. Obviously, when the appellants are charged with an offence under Section 306, that is, abetting the suicide, the focus as well as stress in the cross-examination shall be on that charge alone. At the fag end of the trial, the charge is altered with alternative charge with the framing of the charge under Section 302 IPC. This gives altogether a different complexion and dimension to the prosecution case. Para, now the charge against the appellant was that they have committed murder of Dr. Prasad. In a case like this, addition and or substitution or such a charge was bound to create prejudice to the appellants. Such a charge has to be treated as original charge in order to take care of the said prejudice. It was incumbent upon the prosecution to recall the witnesses, examine them in the context of the charge under Section 302 of IPC, and allow the accused persons to cross-examine those witnesses. Nothing of that sort has happened. As mentioned above, only one witness, that is official witness, namely Deva Reddy, Deputy Superintendent of Police, was examined, and even he was examined on the same date, that is 30 September 2006, when the alternative charge was framed. The case was not even adjourned as mandatorily required under subsection 4 of Section 216 of the Code. para. In a case like this, with the framing of alternative charge on 30th September 2006, testimony of those witnesses recorded prior to that date could even be taken into consideration. Credibility of any witness can be established only after the said witness is put to cross-examination by the accused person. Para. In the instant case, there is no cross-examination of these witnesses in so far as charge under Section 302 IPC is concerned. The trial therefore stands vitiated, and there could not have been any conviction under Section 302 of the IPC. Para. In any case, it is not necessary to go into this aspect because of the reason that even if it is permissible for the prosecution to press the charge under Section 306, and even if it is presumed that such a charge is established, all the appellants have already suffered incarceration for more than 8 years. For the same reason, we do not intend to go into the issue of conviction of these appellants under Section 364 when the charge was framed under Section 365 IPC. We thus reduce the sentence to period already undergone and direct that the appellant shall be released forthwith if not required in any other case. The appeals are accordingly allowed. Total words 784.